With stop-motion animation, your food can spin and jump into place, help your peas and carrots dance, or to tell your next toy story. Let's illustrate your next big idea with stop-motion animation and help your story come to life. So let's get started and I'll show you what you need. First of all, you'll need your computer loaded with Pinnacle Studio 19.5 or newer. You'll need a background, whether it be a plain color or printed images. And of course, you'll need the star of your show, your focus. You'll need your camera, your cord to connect your camera to the computer, and your tripod or a stack of books to bring your camera to the right height. And last but definitely not least, make sure you're in control of the lighting. And this can be as simple as bringing in a desk lamp. So what does this look like all put together? Well, you can see I have my camera set up at the perfect height. It's connected to my computer and the lens is focusing on my characters. So for stop motion animation, you're capturing still frames of your action, but I'm controlling this from the computer. So let's focus in here on my computer screen. You'll see I'll make a slight movement to a character, I'll capture a frame, and then I'll keep repeating that again and again until my story is complete. So let's create our first animation. We'll open Pinnacle Studio and select Import. Along the left-hand side, we'll see stop motion and two options underneath. The integrated camera is the webcam on my computer. The one underneath is the external camera I have plugged in. So let's select this, and you can see it connects to the camera and it's showing me what my lens sees. Along the bottom, you'll see an orange camera. To the right of it, let's select the white arrow and we can control the settings of our camera from our computer. To the right of that, we have autofocus and manual focus and settings to help focus our camera lens from here as well. On the panel of the right, we can control our project settings. We can set our project dimensions, the resolutions, and our frame rates. So for frame rate, we have the option between 60 or 30. So this is how many frames or still images we want per second. So we're going to select 30. Underneath of it, we have the image duration. So this means that each image will last for 2 of those 30 frames per second. So we'll have 15 images for 1 second of playback. So the last icon along the bottom is our onion skin, and what this will do is it'll show a transparent overlay in our frames to help us show the motions we've made. So let's go ahead and capture our first frame. You'll see it'll pop up along the bottom, and now when I go into my characters and make a small movement, I can see the transparency of my last frame underneath, so I can see how far and how big the movement I've made each time. So we'll go and capture this frame. And you can control the settings of onion skin. So if we click on the arrow beside of it, I can control the transparency and also the number of frames I see beneath the current frame. So let's continue on here. We'll capture a few more frames. And you can see when I make this motion, I've made my background less transparent so I can see it a bit clearer. So this feature is great, but it doesn't tell me how much do I have to move each motion to get from point A to B. So let's start over. We'll capture our first frame, and then we'll apply some tools that'll help us gauge how much to move the motion each time. So on the right panel, we have three options, the first of which is like a ruler. If we drag it from our sword from point A to B, you'll see the dots come, and that's telling us how many frames it takes us to get from point A to B. So we can control this, and we say we want it to take 1 second to move from here to there. So with my frame rate and image duration, that would be 15 points on that line we're seeing. So let's make that a bit less. Let's bring this down to half a second, and we'll have about 7 or 8 lines here. So let's go ahead and do this. We're going to move our sword to the next pink dot. We'll capture a frame, and we'll keep repeating this until we've moved the sword all the way along the line. So now let's press play and we'll see what this looks like. So we have two other tools we could have used instead. We have a grid where we can still control the size of the grid lines, which will help us know to move from grid to grid each way. Or we have a circular icon, which is very similar. You can change the size just like this. The last tool in here I want to share with you is auto capture. So if I click on this camera to enable it and click on the white button beside it, I can set up here to take a picture automatically every X seconds. So right now we'll take a picture every 3 seconds and we'll see how that goes. So I'm going to hit capture frame and we'll begin. So the countdown's on. In 3 seconds, it'll take its first picture. So 1, 2, 3, snap. 1, 2, 3, snap. And you'll see there I wasn't quick enough to move my finger, so we can go along the timeline in the bottom and simply delete those 2 frames where you can see my hands in them, and we'll redo them. So we'll move our sword up just a little bit more, and we'll start the capture again for every 3 seconds. And when we're done with it, we can simply hit stop capture. So now let's go ahead and watch our video. So you can see it takes quite a number of frames to get any length in the video, but it's a lot of fun to do it. And when you're done with your story, you can either export to library and have a finished product, or you can export it to the timeline, add some added filters and effects, and play with it within Pinnacle Studio. And that's stop motion animation for you. You can really get creative and use your own props to tell the story your way and bring your animated story to life, and have fun doing it. Thanks for watching!